So next topic in chapter calorimetry is factors affecting the quantity of heat, right? So we are going to see the quantity of heat, how this is going to be affected in terms of absorbing the heat, right? Which increase the temperature of the body. See, we have a body, for example, this is an iron bar, right? This bar is having some kind of heat absorbing. How much energy or how much heat energy is absorbed by this bar is affecting by certain parameter. There are certain constraints which affect the heat capacity or heat quantity of this iron bar, right? Let me take another example. For example, to increase the 1 degree Celsius of water, it requires 4.2 joule per gram per Kelvin, right? So it requires this much of heat energy. On the other hand, to increase the 1 degree Celsius of copper, right, it requires only 0.4 joule per gram per Kelvin, right? So here we can see there are certain parameters which affect the quantity of heat absorbed to increase the temperature of the body. So what are those parameters, right? So the quantity of heat energy absorbed to increase the temperature of the body depends on three factors. There are three factors which affect the energy absorbing capacity of any body. The first factor is the mass of the body. Okay, so first is mass of the body. Okay, that is the first factor. Second factor is the increase in temperature of the body. Increase in temperature of the body. And third factor is the material or substance of the body. Material or substance. We are going to understand all these three factors one by one based on experiment. Okay. So the third is material of the body. Right. So basically, what is the heating capacity or the heat absorbing capacity of any body is depends on the three factor, right? Let's try to understand this by experiment. Okay, so I am writing here experiment number one. Now in experiment number one, we have an object with different mass, and the second point is we will be having the same substance. Okay, I will explain you what does it mean. So the first parameter is different mass, but we'll be having the same substance. What does it means? Means, let's say we are going to do the experiment to raise the temperature of 1 kg of water. Okay, so let's say we having a jar, and this jar is containing 1 kg of water, right? And we are going to heat up this jar. Now we have another jar which contains, let's say, 2 kg of water. This is 2 kg of water, right? So we can see the mass is different, right? We have 1 kg and we have 2 kg. So that means the mass is different. Same substance means we are doing this experiment in water, right? So this is water, and this is again, this is a water. So the experiment is to raise temperature of 1 kg of water by 1 degree Celsius, heat absorbed means, let's say this is heat, right? This is heat, this is flame. Heat absorbed is 1 kilocalorie. So the experiment is, if we try to raise the temperature of this water, which is 1 kg by 1 degree Celsius, then heat absorbed is 1 kilocalorie, right? Now, if we try to raise the temperature, increase the temperature of 2 kg, of 2 kg of water, 2 kg of water by same degree, right, by 1 degree Celsius, then it require 2 kilocalories, right? So that means here we can see the amount of heat energy absorbed is directly proportional to the mass of the object. Means if we are increasing the mass, then kilocalorie or heat absorbing capacity also going to increase in same proportion. Here 1 kg, 1 kilocalorie, 2 kg, 2 kilocalorie. Let's say if we have a 3 kg of water, then it requires 3 kilocalorie of heat energy to increase the 1 degree Celsius. So based on this, we can say in experiment number, let's say heat absorbing capacity is Q and the mass of the water is denominated by M, then this is directly proportion, right? So in this experiment, we can say that the amount of heat energy absorbed is directly proportion to the mass of the body or object, right? And this is, we can say Q is directly proportion to M, right? So this is one of the first derivative or first equation, right? This is also the same, I have just written two times, right? So this is my first equation based on the experiment one. Now let's see experiment number two, where we are going to increase the temperature of the body, right? So here in experiment number one, we have two factors. One is we have different mass and same substance, right? Let's see in experiment number two what we are going to do. Experiment number two. Now here we are going to do two things. One is object with equal mass, okay, means earlier what we have different mass, right? Earlier we have different mass, one is 1 kg and another one is 2 kg, but here we are going to do the same mass, means we are going to try the same experiment with 1 kg of water, right? So this is the equal mass made from same substance. Now this is the same as what we have in last experiment. So same substance. So here we are going to do this 1 kg of water, and water will be the same substance for both the experiment, right? Now let's see what will be the experiment. In experiment, we are going to do, let's say we have a 1 kg of water. Okay, so let's say this is 1 kg of water. right? So to raise the temperature, let me just write it. So to increase the temperature of 1 kg of water by how much? By 1 degree Celsius, heat absorbing capacity. What will be the heat absorbing capacity here? Heat absorbing capacity, it was noticed that, let me just write it, heat absorbing capacity or heat absorbed is 1 kg. Let me just write absorbed, otherwise it may got confused. Heat absorbed is 1 kilocalorie, right? So it was noticed that to raise the temperature of 1 kg of water by 1 degree Celsius, heat absorbed is 1 kilocalorie, right? Now if we do another experiment, while the raise the temperature of same mass of water, let's say here again we'll be having a 1 kg of water, 1 kg of water, but this time we are going to increase the temperature by 2 degree Celsius, right? So to raise the temperature of same mass means 1 kg, same mass of water by 2 degree Celsius, heat required is how much? It was noticed that it was 2 kilocalorie. So for 1 kg of water, 1 degree Celsius, it required 1 kilocalorie. But in case of 1 kg of water of 2 degree Celsius, it required 2 kilocalorie. That means if we do this experiment further, 1 kg of water to increase 3 degree Celsius, it required 3 kilocalorie, and so on so forth, right? So 1 kg of water, 1 degree Celsius, it require 1 kilocalorie. Similarly, if we do this for 1 kg of water to increase 2 degree Celsius, it require 2 kilocalorie. Similarly, 1 kg of water to increase 3 degree Celsius, it require 3 kilocalorie, and so on and so forth. So this is the experiment result. Now based on this, we can say the amount of heat, energy absorbed is directly proportion to what? To raise in temperature, directly proportional to the rise in temperature. That means, and the rise in temperature we denote as a delta T. Why? Because this is the temperature difference, right? This is temperature difference, and that is always been represented by delta T. So if the heating capacity or heat absorbing capacity, as I mentioned, is let's say Q, then that is going to be directly proportion with delta T, and that is your equation number 2, right? So we saw by the same quantity of water, if we try to increase the temperature, then it requires same quantity of heat to increase, right? So that's why to raise the temperature of same mass of water by 2 degree Celsius, it required 2 kilocalorie. If you want to do this for 3 kilocalorie, same mass of water for 3 degree Celsius, then it required 3 kilocalorie, and so on and so forth, right? So that's why this heat energy is directly proportional with the rise in temperature. So that is experiment number 2. Let's see experiment number 3. So experiment number 3 is for what? This is with material. Now here we are going to change the material. We'll try to do this by water and copper, right? So material are changed, right? So let's try to do this with third experiment. So experiment number 3 is where object of same mass means we'll be having a 1 gram of water or 1 gram of copper. So mass is same but made from different substance. Now here substance is different substance, right? So one is what? One is copper and another one is water, right? Now the experiment is, let's say this is a copper 1 gram and let's say we have a water of 1 gram water and this is copper. So it was observed that if equal mass of water and copper, right, 1 gram and 1 gram are heated, let's say this is also heated to 1 degree Celsius, the amount of heat absorbed by water is almost 10 times of copper. Okay, let's say copper absorbed x amount of heat, so this will be 10x, right? So the amount of heat absorbed by water is nearly 10 times the amount of heat absorbed by copper. And we have saw few moments back when I was explaining this calorimeter very first topic that for increase of 1 degree Celsius of water it requires 4.2 joule per gram per Kelvin, but in case of copper if to increase the temperature of 1 degree Celsius it requires 4.2 joule per gram per Kelvin. So here we can see in copper it requires very less energy, very less heat to increase the same temperature of 1 degree Celsius. So that's why we can say it's been almost 10 times a water is absorbing the heat to increase the same value of temperature, which is 1 degree Celsius, right? So the amount of heat absorbed depends on the substance, right? If we are changing the substance, the absorbing capacity will be changed, right? So what we have concluded based on this experiment, we have concluded that the amount of heat energy absorbed depends on what? Depends on the substance, right? If we change the substance, the heat absorbing capacity also drastically changed. Okay, substance of the object. and this is been represented as specific heat capacity. This is what we called as a specific heat capacity, and this is denoted as C, small c. Now, based on equation number 1, what we have saw in equation number 1, which is equation number 1 was Q is directly proportional to M. In equation number 2, we saw Q is directly proportional to delta T, right? Equation number 2 is Q is directly proportional to delta T. So we can say in experiment number 3, we have one more constant, which is C. So based on all three experiments, we can say Q is equal to C M delta T, where C is the constant. C is the constant of proportionality, which we called as specific heat capacity, right? So C depends upon the substance. If substance is copper, then the specific heat capacity of copper we can enter here. If the substance is water, then we can mention the specific heat capacity of the water. But this mass and this temperature, the rise in temperature or the delta T, can be changed, but this is the constant of that substance, right? And it is a characteristic of substance and is different from different substance, right? So we can see it depends upon the substance. So friend, this is all about the factors affecting the quantity of heat. We saw by three experiment number 1, 2 and 3.